In this video, I'm going to show you how connections can be either optimally used or they could be abused. When I talk about connections, I'm talking about how an application connects to the database and makes use of the connection. There are two ways in which an application could work. It could either use a connection pool, or whenever a user needs to perform an operation, it creates a new connection. So I'm going to give you a very simple demonstration. I have two scripts here, or rather four scripts. So there is a script called connection script bad, which uses a internal script called block in bad.sql. And there's a connection script good, which uses the block in good SQL. Let's first look at what the script connection script bad does. So this is an OS script, and I've got some output parameters that are mentioned. So basically I have two loops. The first loop iterates 10 times, and the inner loop iterates 10 times within each loop of the outer. And all that I'm doing is making a new connection and running the script in block in bad. And I also give a feedback at the end of every loop iteration completes. Let's go and look at block in bad. So if you look at the overall execution, this script is going to be run 100 times. But then every time it is going to perform this script execution, it is creating a login. Let's next see what does the connection script good does. So the connection script good makes a connection and then uses the same SQL. Let me open the script block in good. Now if you open this and see, it's just got a server output on enabled. It is also doing a PL SQL execution, and it is doing a 10 outer loop. And then within each outer loop, it is doing 1,000 executions, and it's doing the same SQL as the other script. So if you go back and see what the block in bad did, it did a count star into V1 from a table called test data. Whereas what is my script here doing? It is also doing a count star into VN from app1 test. I also have a feedback mechanism through which I tell how much time it took for each loop to do and total time taken to complete the entire operation. Let's now see how each of these scripts run. I'm going to run the connection script bad first. And remember, this script is going to do 100 execution of the select count query. So the script started at a particular point, and we look at the feedback that is coming from the script. We see that for every 10 executions, it's taken about 1 second. And if I look at the total time taken, it started at 2121 and finished at 2131, which is like it took 10 seconds overall for this script to execute. And in each of these executions, it executed 10 times the query. Let's look at what my good connection script does. So I'm going to run this. What happened here? Now remember, the script is running 1,000 times the same SQL in one loop, and the entire operation finished within less than 1 second. The first script, the bad script, just executed 100 times the SQL select count of star into V1, whereas the good script ran it 10,000 times. So if you look at the comparison, to do 10 executions by logging in, perform the query and get out, I took 1 second for every 10. Whereas if I just created one connection and repeated the execution every time, 100 executions actually happened in a millisecond, less than a millisecond, and the entire 10,000 operations finished in less than a second. So please keep note of this and ensure your applications perform connections appropriately. They don't make connections as the application is running, unless you are using a thick client wherein on logon it makes a connection and after that connection is maintained. or at an application server, create a connection pool wherein the application pre-creates the connection and keeps it, and every time an application user performs an operation, a connection from the connection pool is picked by the application and executes the SQL, rather than creating a new connection for every operation or for every user. Thanks for watching the demo and wish you all the best in ensuring connection management is optimal in your applications connecting to the Oracle database.